Looking at a bicycle seat might be an unusual way to start a lockpicking video, but a lot of you found this on the internet. This is called the Seaty, and is a bicycle seat with an integrated bicycle lock. Very cool, they say, at least in the picture here, you can convert it from a seat into a bicycle lock in like 10 seconds. Not a lot to it, very easy to do. We do have a couple of keys here, and you'll notice they are slider keys, so I thought that'd be interesting. On the bottom is a folding. These are probably hardened steel. It folds out so you can fit it between your spokes. And there, of course, is the lock. I recently found a pretty easy way to open up slider locks, and I was just curious if we'd be able to do that on the Seaty in roughly the same amount of time it would take to convert it from a seat into a lock. That would not be a good thing, but thought it might be interesting to try. Let me go ahead and unpackage it. The packaging is very heavy, first of all. Everything that you see here weighs just under 5 pounds, be 2.7 kilograms. So right away, it's not for lightweight bicyclists, but good security locks rarely are light. So let's go ahead and take it apart, take a look at that lock, see if we can pick our way into it. All right, guys, let's get the important thing out of the way right up front. I tried picking this for an hour and a half, and I was not successful. So before we start talking about the lock and I explain why I believe that was, let's take a look at some of the details now that I've got this thing out of what apparently was some pretty heavy packaging. The seat as it mounts on your bicycle weighs 3 pounds, 13.6 ounces, which is about 1¾ kilograms. So it's quite heavy, and so you might have detected my weight weaniness. I like lightweight mountain bikes, and the lighter they are, the easier they are to climb up hills. But this is clearly made for touring style bikes, and you know, of course, that should have been obvious to the most casual observer right through the packaging. So let's take a look at some of those details. Now, whether you're a bicycle racer or a bicycle tourer, there's one really important design feature of this seat that you really need to take note of, and that would be this groove right here and this cutout. Particularly important to male riders, for those of you who've ridden bikes for quite a while. You know how disconcerting it is to, you know, detect maybe some very slight tingling, reach down and check your equipment, and everything is dead numb. You can feel nothing. Well, there's a nerve down there, and by putting this little depressed area in the cutout here, it takes the pressure off that nerve, and for long-distance riders, you won't have to worry about that numb feeling that none of us really like. God, I hope it comes back! Anyway, it is a very plush seat. It's very well done, very well stitched. I can say nothing bad about the seat as a touring seat. When we take a look from this side, you'll notice that I have the mount. Now you notice it has a twin rail. This is a standard mount for any modern seat post bike. This clamps directly onto the mounting rail. So this is what it will look like. And when you're ready to lock up your bike, all you do, there's a quick release lever here. You flip that up and you slide it right off. And that remains with your bike. And that is your lock. So let's flip it over again. Let's take a look at some of the engineering that went into this thing. They didn't appear to cut any corners. They put heavy stapling all around the perimeter. They're right up next to each other, as you can see. So this is not going to be falling apart anytime soon. Where most of the stress, the tension of trying to pull the fabric out, they have a crimped plastic held in place with screws. And there's also a plastic mount with high security screws or anti-tamper screws that hold the mount for the lock on. I really don't know why they did that, because the front of the lock is actually molded into the front of the seat. So removing those really won't get you anything. It won't get you into the lock. So I don't know why they did it that way, but that's what we got. All right, now we get to this evil lock. What I thought was going to be, at least from looking at this key, an easy rake job turned out not to be so easy. And that is because when you look inside of here, you can see in the front of that there's some warding where it prevents access to the sliders. Now, in this case, I'm trying to look inside of there. The sliders are on this side right now, on the left side. There's one on the top and one on the bottom. What I will tell you, when you apply tension to the core of this lock, whatever position those sliders are in is where they're locked into. They're not going to move. So I was unable to apply tension and then rake those sliders because they're completely seized up. So we got dual sidebars, And unless those sliders are in exactly the right position, as they would be with the key, when you apply the rotational pressure on the core, you are not getting into that lock. So really, really well done. It's not your run-of-the-mill slider, I've got to say. They put a lot of thought. This is more in line with, I think, the Miwa design, which is a very complex lock. I haven't busted it apart, and maybe I'll do that later. In terms of the lock itself, it's a standard articulated lock. Once we have it removed, we can unfold this very easily. And there's your articulated arm lock, just held together or just bolted to the seat. No big deal. A couple nice things about this. On these articulated arms, we've looked at these before and identified a couple of glaring weaknesses. And one of them was right here. But you'll notice, I mean, we were able to take a screwdriver and actually pry the locking bolt out of the lock. It broke it, I'll grant you that, but it was a pretty easy way to get into that lock. CD lock didn't cut any corners. And let me unlock it, and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So we slide key in, have to rotate it 180 degrees, not a partial turn, but complete 180. Only then can you remove the locking arm. Now the locking housing itself is made out of very heavy, very thick aluminum that's cast as part of the lock. And I don't think you're going to be breaking that off with any quick hammer blows. Very solid, very well thought out. And it protects something that, again, it's not held in place with a screw. So even if you break it off, it's really not going to be gaining you anything. This is definitely pressed into place. So a couple of locks before, we were able to take a screw out right there and the locking bolt came off and the arm came open. You don't see that here. So that's definitely not going to be a weakness. One of the other weaknesses we found on these, again, a pretty glaring weakness, was caused by bean counters. When the bean counters cut corners on some of the designs, they used not so bad materials, but they used really junky pins. I don't know if CD Lock did that or not, but I'm going to find out. And the way we find out is we take a pair of bolt cutters or a pair of croppers, we wedge it into that crack, and we try to pinch it to wedge these two pieces apart. And if the metal pin is soft, generally it'll shear off very easily. Another place we've seen the bean counters cut corners are these arms. These are covered up with plastic, so I really can't get a good idea yet. But if they cut the corners here and used a substandard grade of lower level of hardness for these steel rods on the arms, we'll find out because I'm going to take a hacksaw and try to cut through there. So far, I am impressed with what I see. And I hate to have to destroy the lock to confirm it, but hey, that's what we do around here. We break stuff. All right, for the first test, I'm going to use some 24-inch croppers. These are not so huge as to be unconcealable by a criminal. I did try to fit them on, and the knuckle here is too large to fit into the jaw. So instead, this first test, I'm simply going to take my croppers and try to cut through the articulated arm just to see what happens. That was cutting through the plastic. And okay, so the 24-inch croppers are probably not going to do much other than cut through that plastic. That's okay. I have some big boys. Not so easy to conceal, but they might go large enough to put onto the articulated joint. So let's try that. See if I can get it to grip. Almost a two-man job to hold on to these things. I don't think it's gonna lock on there, so let's just stick with the original tack of... I have to move the camera a bit because these arms are all the way open. Let's try it right there. That ought to be good. And let's see if I can put the jaws on here and get a cut. All right, so I think it's pretty obvious no metal is going to be impermeable to 48-inch jaws or die grinders or anything else, but again, these things are so heavy and so large, it's really not a tool that I think a criminal is going to be carrying around. So let's go back to the bench. I'm going to cut the plastic off, and let's see what kind of damage the 24-inchers did, just out of curiosity. All right, I know carrying around 48-inch bolt cutters, as heavy and big as they are, is not a realistic tool for a criminal, but I just wanted to be able to figure out if we could cut through this, and we did, but it took the giant bolt cutters. That 24-incher, when I took the plastic away, with all of my strength on 24-inch bolt cutters, all I did was just put that very tiny pinch mark on both sides. So this is definitely not a place where the CD lock engineers or bean counters cut any corners. I was also curious about the pin, so I went to work on that just out of curiosity. I beat the devil out of this thing with a hammer, and then I tried to wedge a chisel up inside of there. And when I got all that plastic peeled away, you can see that they put some hardened spring steel coils in there to protect the bearings and also to protect that pin. So with all the beating, and you can see this thing really went through it, I was not even able to get a chisel wedged through that spring steel to even access that pin. So whether it's soft or not at this point really is irrelevant. I doubt it, given the quality of engineering that I've seen so far on this CD lock. I gotta say, everything from the quality of the lock, the outstanding mounting system, the hardness of the steel that's involved, I gotta say, I give these guys a thumbs up. I was a little skeptical when I looked at the CD lock through the package. Again, being a weight weenie, I like lightweight. 3 pounds, though. By the time I take my racing bike seat and then add a chain and a lock to it, I'm right at 3 pounds anyway. Why not incorporate it so that my junk doesn't get numb? I wish I had that on my bike. Anyway, guys, this will not be much of a giveaway this week. I apologize, but the only way to answer questions about the quality of the material is actually to do destructive testing, and I think we did that. So the giveaway this week will not be this busted up CD lock. Instead, I'm going to throw in one of my Corian engraved pinning trays, those experimental pinning trays. I'm also going to throw in a brand new Praxis kit from UK Bump Keys. Not this one. Instead, I've got a brand new one still in the wrapper, so you will get that. And then the last thing I'll throw in will be something fairly new from Sparrows. Will be this guy. It's the Sparrows Bump Hammer. It's actually the kit. So in the kit, you get a bump hammer. You get a series, you can't really see them through the package, but a variety of different bump keys. And you also get the very difficult to find castration rings or donuts that go onto the keys, so you can use that machine gun action to continually strike that bump key. These are really hard to find, but Sparrows found them and they included them in their kit. Anyway, guys, there's a giveaway. If you'd like to know how to do it, all you need to do is navigate to locklab.com, the tribal website, and scroll down in the middle of the page. You'll see all the giveaway buttons, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. But the one you're looking for is the Weekend Review Giveaway, purple band. Just click on it. It'll take you to the registration page. Again, scroll to the bottom, put in a good email address, so if you win, I can get in touch with you, let you know. Put in a username, doesn't matter what it is, and click submit. When you're done, you'll get a green check mark confirming your entry. Thanks, guys. All right, guys, appreciate your time. Stay safe, stay legal. CD Lock, you guys did a great job on this. Again, thumbs up to all your designers and engineers. Thanks, guys. Lock Lab, where the fun begins.